We've been taking it a bit slow on the house recently because, well, I've damaged my shoulder a little bit, but we've got the water and the electrics sort of up to a point where they're running enough for us to survive.
We've got hot water in the house, we've got running water in the bathroom, we've got kitchen running water, hot water. The electrics are all in the kitchen.
Yeah, so...
The bathroom.
We've decided to live the good life, basically, for a little bit.
Yeah, but so last year when we moved over, we haven't had a holiday in 2 years.
Yeah.
And we've been working flat out, so we've been having a bit of a downtime.
Yeah.
We've been having some us time, and we've been off exploring, haven't we?
Yeah, so we decided to... There's over 330, at least 330 chateaus in the local area, and we found some really cracking chateaus to look at, and we've been looking at Brocante and everything like that in the local area. And everyone knows about Dan from Escape to Rural France, his chateau, you know, derelict chateau. And there's, well, between us and Dan's chateau, which is about 25 miles from us, there's at least 4 or 5 derelict chateaus. And there's a derelict chateau sort of like about, I don't know, 5 miles from us, and there's another derelict chateau, say 10 miles from us. So
there's a lot.
So we thought we'd show you a derelict chateau quite close to us, really. It was built around about 1860 by an inventor and a chemist. I think he was mayor to the local town at one point. It was sort of, I think it was occupied in the 1950s. In the 1960s, I think they tried to sell it off in parts, you know, as sort of flats or something like that. Certainly in the 1980s, it was definitely empty in the 1980s. In 2006, basically there was a massive fire and all the roof was burnt off. So that was basically the end of the chateau. And if it was England, they'd put big barriers and fences up around everything, and they'd prevent everyone from going in, wouldn't they? And say, oh, dangerous, you know, don't go in, hard hats and everything. But this is France. What do? They've put in a car park. And they've put in a picnic area, which seems a little bit strange to us Brits, doesn't it really?
It does. However, there are houses nearby, so I think it might be for them as opposed to the chateau. It's just, it's next to the chateau.
It's next to the chateau. So
which is great for parking.
It's great for parking, really. So, we parked up and we had a look round, really. So, yeah.
Have a look.
Have a look. Yeah. Enjoy. lovely metal railings.
Thank you.
Nature's taken over us now. Thank you.
greenhouse.
That chateau, I wouldn't.
yeah,
definitely not.
Yeah, it's a lot of work, but as most people have seen on Dan's escape to rural France, where there's a will, there's definitely a way. But as usual,
you've got to have that mentality.
Yeah,
yeah.
And as usual, folks, give us a bit of the old like and subscribe. We love a bit of that,
and we'll see you next time.
Next time,
au revoir.